my channel. So today for you guys, I have a DIY, and this DIY is a beach nautical themed DIY, and I haven't done one of these in a long time. Normally do this around the summertime because beach decor, I don't know, makes the most sense otherwise. I think it depends where you live though, but in Chicago during the winter time to have beach decor doesn't make the most sense. Let me know which DIY is your favorite down in the comments below. Mine is actually this one that you see right here because I like that it looks like water. It's not water, but it has like a water appearance to it. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. As always, if you do, please give it a thumbs up. Let's see if we can get this video to 5,000 thumbs up. And let me know if you want to see more beach decor videos. I tend to do farmhouse DIYs because that is what performs the best on YouTube, and that's mainly what people want to see. I do like glam DIYs, but farmhouse is honestly something that's more consistent for me. And now that it's summertime, I do know beach decor is a popular theme to decorate with. So let me know if you want to see beach decor DIYs, some more of them. Before we begin, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell notification down below to be notified every single time that I upload. With that being said, let's begin the video. Let's start with my favorite DIY, this tray. I'm gonna call it a tray because I don't really know what else to call it. So from Dollar Tree, you wanna pick up one of their cake or pie pans. The cake pan is smaller, and that is what I'm going to be using. Now, I went ahead and I used a white chalk paint and some makeup sponges to paint my cake pan. Now, you don't really have to make sure you paint the sides. I ended up painting them, but they're gonna end up being covered. You honestly don't have to paint at all. I just wanted there to be white showing if any of the cake pan was showing at all. I just preferred the white color versus the cake pan natural color. Now, once I have my cake pan painted, I'm now going to glue on some nautical rope, and I'm gluing two layers of that nautical rope on top of each other on the very top of the pan. The reason I'm doing this is I'm going to be adding some little wood logs from Dollar Tree all around this. The wood logs need something to attach to, and all it's really going to be able to attach to on the cake pan is the very thin edging. It won't be able to stick to the entire cake pan because of the way that the cake pan goes down in a slant. So I add the nautical rope to add some layer to the cake pan that the logs can attach to. You don't have to use nautical rope per se. I use nautical rope because it matches the beach theme. But you could use anything that you like. You just need something for the logs to attach to, because if you just try to glue it directly to that small little edging on the cake pan, more than likely it's gonna fall off eventually. To glue the logs on, I'm using a hot glue gun. What I'm doing is I'm putting glue on the nautical rope and that slight edge on the cake pan, attaching my log piece, and then any other log piece I put on now, I go ahead and do what I did before, but I also put some glue on the log piece beside it. So all the log pieces are attached to each other with glue, as well as attached to the nautical rope. So it's just trying to apply as much glue to this as I possibly can so it doesn't fall apart on me. Now, you could use a heavy duty glue, but the thing is, there's like, I don't know what to call it exactly, but it's like wood skin, that's what I would call it, and it does shed. So even if you use a heavy duty glue, that doesn't mean that the logs are just gonna stay put. The best advice I have for you is when you move this thing around, you do it very gently because, like I said, there's not a lot of surface for the logs to be attached to. So the very bottom of those logs, you know, it's not attached to anything. So just be very careful when you're picking this thing up. As long as you pick it up gently, it's gonna be fine. It's more so if you just pick this thing up by the log pieces without even thinking about it, there's a good chance it might fall apart on you. You want to pick it up in the inside of the cake pan and then the outside of the log pieces. Now, originally I thought that I was going to make this more of like a stand, and so I got this candle pillar from Dollar Tree. I went ahead and I painted it white, and then I attached it to the bottom of my tray. I ended up doing this, but I didn't end up keeping it this way. So now to the inside of this, I am adding sand. The sand is from Dollar Tree. I just have it in a big Ziploc bag because it's sand that I previously used. There's some marbles from Dollar Tree in my sand, so I had to pick them all out. But I went ahead and I added a layer of sand. And then I started to add some of these little sea gems from Dollar Tree. I added a couple of them to the bottom, as well as some seashells. So it kind of looked like the bottom of an ocean floor, except those sea gems, they're not in the bottom of an ocean floor, not at all, but the blues kind of help make it look a little bit more like water.
Now, to kind of make this look like water, I'm using this cutting board from Dollar Tree. It's the perfect size for the cake pan from Dollar Tree. I just placed it right on top of the sand, and the way that that looks, it kind of looks like water, and I thought it looked really cool. Now I'm just adding little things here and there. This boat is from Hobby Lobby. I got it for 50% off, so I paid around $5 for it. I'm adding more of that sea glass, as well as this little jar of seashells that is from Dollar Tree. Throw in some more seashells, and then I got this little, it looks like a tiny little suitcase or even like a treasure chest from Hobby Lobby. I got it for $1.50, and I put that inside. I ended up putting some of that sea glass inside of there, so it kind of looked like treasure. So you can put whatever you want in this. There are plenty of items you can use from Dollar Tree. It doesn't have to be, you know, from Hobby Lobby. You just want to decorate this however you like. And that is it for this little tray. And I really, really like it because, like I said, it kind of looks like there's water inside of there. It looks like my boat is just floating on top of water. It's really, really cute. Now moving on to this cute framed home decor. I've done lots of DIYs like this before, but this one I'm doing with a beach theme. I'm using these 4x6 picture frames. There's a slight difference in color between the ones I bought, and I didn't notice it. One's a little bit more blue and one's a little bit more green, and I did not notice that until I bought them. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take these activity sheet pads. They have a wooden appearance. It's almost just like scrap paper for crafting, and I'm using the white wood that's in there to place inside of my picture frames. I'm using 9 of them total. I take the contents out of the picture frame, I take the glass piece, place my paper over that, and just kind of bend it to the shape of the glass piece, cut it down, and then I place it inside of the frame. And I do that to all 9 picture frames. And then I start to glue the frames together. Now what I noticed with the green and blue picture frames, the blue one was slightly bigger than the green one, so I had to arrange them so that they would all line up perfectly when I glued them together. So if you end up buying blue and green ones and not noticing it, you just want to make sure you line it up before gluing it together so everything matches up perfectly. And I just use a hot glue to glue them all side by side, as well as popsicle sticks on the back to adhere them to each other more nicely, just secure them together. People like to use foam board, but I stopped using foam board a long time ago because popsicle sticks is where it's at. It doesn't make it all bulky in the back, and it still leaves it so that you would be able to hang it up on the wall using a nail and the hooks that are already on the back of the picture frame. If you do it with the foam board, you're forced to just put it on top of something like a mantle, or use command strips to hang it up to the wall if you want to. I do recommend using an industrial glue to glue this all together. I just used a hot glue for video purposes, but industrial glue is going to make this much more secure, and you'll be able to fix any mistakes that you make easily because industrial glue doesn't glue right away. And by industrial glue, I mean like E6000 Gorilla Glue, super glue. Now what I start to do is I start to glue on some seashells. These seashells are from Dollar Tree, and then I did put a starfish in the middle that's not from Dollar Tree. That is from Hobby Lobby. It came in a pack of a bunch of starfish. It was $3.99, but I ended up using a 40% off coupon, so I got it for less than that. Now you can leave it just like this, just 9 picture frames if you want to cut your cost. But I decided that I wanted to add more picture frames to kind of just add a little bit more to this. So I'm using these galvanized metal picture frames. I'm taking the galvanized metal pieces off and using the picture frame itself. I go ahead and I remove the little tabs that are inside of the picture frame. Usually the tabs in the Dollar Tree picture frames are easy to remove. I had a little bit of a harder time to remove these ones. I'm using 5 of them total, and I'm just gluing them to 5 of the frames, the blue frames. You don't have to do this at all. This is just another option if you want to do something. I just really like the way that this looked, and that's why I decided to do this. And to glue those, I ended up using industrial glue just because I didn't want to make a mistake with the hot glue and it dried too quickly and then mess this up. And that's it for these framed seashells. Now moving on to these candles that are similar to something I did a couple years ago, inspired by Pottery Barn glasses. So from Dollar Tree, you want to pick up some nautical rope as well as some of their glasses. They have different sizes. I went with more of the cylinder shapes. Now what you do is you glue nautical rope to the very bottom of the glass and wrap it around to the height that you want it to be. So I stopped about 1/3 of the way. I just used my hot glue gun and made sure I got hot glue on every inch of that nautical rope. Now I'm going to be adding some starfish. These starfish that I got them at Michael's. I used a 50% off coupon, so I paid $2 for them. There's three in a pack. I go ahead and I glued on the medium size one onto the very front of my little candle pillar. If you want to use only Dollar Tree products, you can use just their seashells. And then I did the same thing to another glass that I got from Dollar Tree. This one had like a different top to it. It's just a little bit larger than the one I used previously. So to this one, I added the nautical rope. Then I placed a larger starfish on the very front of that. And then I added some seashells from Dollar Tree. I added seashells to this one because this is the largest one. So the one I would want in the center of all three candle pillars that I have, and it would tie the first one that I made together with the second one that I have from the previous DIY I did years ago. And that one I used jute twine from Dollar Tree and then seashells from Dollar Tree. And that's it for the candle holders. They're really inexpensive and easy to make, and I think they're very nice. Now moving on to the last DIY, which is not really a DIY. I think all you guys know you can get the nautical rope from Dollar Tree and wrap it around some styrofoam balls or baseballs to create the little filler balls. But Dollar Tree right now pretty much carries those made for you. If you go into the dog toy section right now, they have these little rope balls for dogs. Now, most of the ones you're going to see are colorful. You have to dig for the regular nautical rope color ones, or the white one, or the beige one. If you're not able to find it, you can go ahead and just buy the ball as is and then paint it. And it's already pretty much done for you. You don't have to deal with the gluing, and you get a pretty cool shape out of it. So that's why I said this is a DIY, but not really a DIY. It just depends if you end up having to paint the ball. Just look inside of the dog section. Anyways, that is it for these beach decor DIYs. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And again, if you want to see more beach decor DIYs, let me know down in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys next time. Take care. Bye.